We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders. It is in our hands to leave these dark machines behind, the dark ages where they belong, and to press forward to cap a historic movement towards a new world order and a long era of peace.
Out of these troubled times, our fifth objective, a new world order, can emerge. Now we can see a new world coming into view. A world in which there is a very real prospect of a new world order. It's more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order, where diverse nations are drawn together in common cause to achieve the universal aspirations of mankind, peace and security, freedom, and the rule of law.
We had a worldview. Republican and Democratic presidents alike, from Harry Truman to George Bush. And after 1989, President Bush kept said, and it was a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order.
Time and time again about a new world order. And this is the best chance to begin to establish the new world order.